All right, so we're back. Me and Philip's going to review this Chinese Special Forces ration. We just got this in the mail from Taiwan, I believe, was the oddly enough. That was the hub to get this. So this says menu number 2. This translates to self-heating Special Forces ration. This was self-heating mushroom, bamboo shoots, roast pork, self-heating multi-grain rice, 250 gram braised quail egg. Thought it was braised quail at first, but it's braised quail egg. That should be nasty. Let's see how it works out. We never know. The past Chinese rations actually been pretty decent, but this is a little bit different one, so we don't know what we're looking at here. Forgot how much this even was. I think it was, hell guys, I don't remember. 50, 60 bucks. Something like that. It was fairly expensive. It really was. So on the back here, we have a little tiny pinhole there. But actually, there's a tear notch. Oh, but damn. I'll be. One thing about it, too, it doesn't feel like it's Chinese-y plastic. Like, usually everything's real crackly. This is not that way. Okay, so we do see something familiar in here at this point. We have a little tray, and it is like some of the other rations to where it has the two different packets for your mains already done up in the ration heater. So all we got to do is put water to it. Is this a quail egg? Oh boy. Oh boy. So the multigrain rice is in with the mains. We'll have to translate this and come back. We have a sauce. Ordinarily, that is either a spicy sauce. We'll know as soon as we open it, or it is a sesame sauce. I'm not sure what this is. We'll know the second we open that up what that is. First thing I do is get a bottle of water. We're going to heat these up and then get out our little tray. There should be a spoon or some arrangement of something in here, maybe chopsticks, and that's like your dish to eat it in. So let's give it a try. This is spicy sauce. This is dried, shows up dried radish, but I think it's probably pickled radish. This one won't translate. We're fairly certain that's a quail egg. We'll know soon enough. Oh, there's all kinds of surprises. Didn't even see that one. This one is totally unmarked, so we'll see coming up with that. All right, first things first, the way these operate, we'll cut the top of it off like that. Then they give you a little bag to measure the water with. And the old Chinese ration heaters, there's one thing Chinese can make that's good is ration heaters. There's not a lot other I could say, but ration heaters are always 10 out of 10. Probably as soon as I say that, it won't work, but that's just the way it is. Aggressive.
Yeah, they work.
Real aggressive. Put a little bit on the table. Why not? That one's a little bit low on the water, but it's totally fine. I'll look down here and make sure which side the element's on. It's on this side. Put that side down. Okay, so the one's pretty much done. This one's won't be much longer. Let's go ahead and get our little tray out here, a cardboard tray. We have a little accessory kit, if you will. Little square spoon. This almost has like a greenish tint to it, but it's black. Put that right there. Napkin. If you use ever toilet paper, let me tell you what. There's not much going there. And you got a toothpick. So first things first, while that's finishing up here, I'm curious what this is. Probably some kind of dried noodle type situation, or even like some kind of bean sprout. So I think this is actually the soup cube. I'm pretty certain. I can smell of it and see. So usually these are soups.
Is it strong?
Yep. Very, very, very salty. So let me grab a mug here. All right, so let's go ahead and do our soup cube. I mean, that's it, all right? Look at the different colors in that baby. You got green, red. Looks to be maybe some noodles that are yellow in there. Like I said, there's nothing all in the package. So we're on with it. We've had soups like this before. Let's know what it is. Go easy on the amount of water in this too. I'd say probably we'll start with something like that. We'll let her float around there like a, you know what I was going to say. Okay, so it all broke up really quick and easy. Let's just go ahead and leave it to do its thing there. These bad boys are done. And should be pretty dang hot. Let's see. There it is. I was going to say all the effort, and then it put a tear notch down a little, but they actually did. Is this one only the rice? Let's find out. There's only one way to know. That would make sense if it was. If I make this a single meal, usually these you get two different mains. But let's just see what we got. There's no way to know. There's no translation quite good enough here to tell what's what. Yes, this is rice. So when you open this one first, that has some hot rice. All right, so let's dump this in our trough here. Fling that to trash. Let's get a spoon. Let's use our spoon that came with it. A smoking hot rice. Kind of sucks this thing because the sides are so high, it's hard to see down in it. So usually how these operate, they give you two different meals and then you pour them both in here. So like one side you have the rice of the food, and the other side you have the rice of the food. It's separated. It's kind of like a lot going on here. I feel like this is a different kind of rice. This is not as fresh usually when we do these, but there again, usually the meat's already mixed in with it. So it kind of keeps it all soft. And then let's go and cut this one open. This is our... Oh yeah. There we go. Right to the trash can. We got crap all over the table. So let's go in here and take a look. And I'm trying to pick out what's what in here. Mushroom and bamboo shoots. So obviously this is the mushroom. There's not really too much in this one, to be honest with you. Bamboo shoots probably going to be that, maybe. Let's try it. Actually, it has a very nice, like, beefy taste to it. That rice leaves something to be desired. It's not hard rice, but it's like dry. Come on.
Everything just falls off.
It's fairly oily. It's like
chunks.
The rice is very firm. So what's your first impression of it? It's like beefy, the mushroom part, kind of. So here's our radish. No go? Weird? The dirty old pickled radish.
It's very chewy.
The rice or the mushroom?
I mean both. There's some beef in there as well.
I'm going to grab a fork for this. All these pickled relishes, radishes, pickled vegetables, relish type sides are all very, very weird. This video's going downhill. Dropping everything. Can't talk right. So it's not dried radish, it's pickled radish. What's that smell like? Sauerkraut.
Yeah, it does.
It's not bad. I'll try a little bit. You like sauerkraut?
No, you go ahead. I'm good.
That's Philip's way of saying hell no. It's not bad. What it's supposed to do here, that's what it's supposed to do. It's supposed to dump it on her, obviously. There you go. Squeeze on out of there. And I know it's going to be weird, but I promise you that I'll make it a lot better.
I think if it's all mixed together, it'd probably be better.
I think that's what they're going for. Then, let's do the quail egg first. We assume that's what this is. Oh boy. Oh boy.
Oh?
What does that smell like? Soy sauce?
Kinda. It's not very strong, actually.
Do you want to try your quail egg, sir?
Yes.
Okay.
I think that'd be pretty good, actually.
I'm gonna harpoon you one here. Or maybe half of one.
It might be connected.
Yep. Let me spoon feed you like a little baby? No, there you go. He's like, no. Like a marinated quail egg. There you go. You can see the cross shot of it. I mean, it's weird. Pickle with soy sauce, maybe? Is that what they were going for? And then last up, spicy sauce. That could be a wide range of things.
The quail is kind of weird. It's not bad, though.
It's not as strong. I thought it was going to be really strong.
I think everything in this meal is actually kind of bland. But maybe this soy... Is it soy sauce or is it hot sauce?
This is spicy. I'm just going to put just like a little drip.
Spicy sauce. That would probably liven it up.
This is probably... sesame oil. Not as hot as I thought it was. Almost looks like jelly. It's actually pretty good. It's like a real... almost like a beef stock kind of taste to it. Mm-hmm. A tiny, tiny, tiny bit of size. You want to try some of this or what?
Sure.
He's like, yeah, until you dump the damn sauerkraut over top of that thing. The rice kind of messes the whole thing up because it's like hard, not hard, but it's like real dry. It'd be better with a really good rice. However, this is not a bad meal, but there's also not very much of it either. That's a bold amount. It's not hot though, not really. It's like a beef stock kind of taste to it, you think, or not?
Yeah, it's like soy sauce.
But not as, it's not like straight salt. You know, it kind of is, but not to the extent. Okay.
I mean, everything is very tame compared to the last.
Right. So our soup, probably like maybe bean sprouts, some kind of peppers in it. I don't know what that is, but it doesn't look, it's like some innards from something, probably a bean sprout, we'll say it's that. Well, it's got a little bit of salt to it. I'll try a, or I'll hand it back to you. Same way, it's not overly overpowering. A little bit salty, kind of like a some kind of weird vegetable soup.
It's actually very salty.
Probably need more water with it, to be honest. But this stuff, I'm going to try to get a, let's do this. Let's do like it's intended. Cut the quail egg in half. Piece of quail egg. Sauerkraut. Bean sprout. Mushroom.
There you go.
Okay.
Is that good, Nathan?
That is an intent for it, though. We all mix together. It gives like a lot more of a like a meal type feel to it, where it's not just like it takes all the ingredients together to make it a lot better. I'm thinking probably what's going to happen when they eat this. The soldier would probably dump that in there too. Probably put everything in there, mix it up and whip it down and move on.
That'd be better.
And if they don't like one of the things that's in it, they could just leave it out. That's my thoughts on it. I'm sure somebody have different thoughts in the comments. That's going to be it for today's video. Overall, a small ration, very interesting, but it's edible.
It's edible.
We've had some stuff that wasn't, but this one is.
Yeah.
As far as foreign rations, as far as Chinese rations go, it's probably like a 6 out of 10, I would say.
I think the other one we had, I'm trying to think back, but I feel like I had more ingredients that were unique.
It was a lot easier. I mean,
this is more.
They had like two whole mains. It was like a lot of stuff. It was noodles and rice.
Right.
And it was ready out of the pouch with the sides. But the sauces on that weren't as good.
Yeah.
No quail eggs.
Quail eggs were probably my favorite.
I'd say as four rations go as a whole. And art and genetics is going to drive us towards more European stuff, like French stuff, Norwegian stuff. Like that's kind of what we're mentally trained to like. This isn't too bad. So yeah, if you guys want one of these, well, good luck. They're difficult to find. This was an eBay purchase. It took about 2 weeks to get here. So if you want one, you gotta dig through eBay and try to locate that and roll the dice with shipping. This one got here unopened. That does not guarantee that yours will. And that's gonna be it. Thanks for watching. We'll see you back again very soon with another video.